Hello everybody, my name is Case Teselski. I'm the creator of the Digital Connections of KB National Library. Today I'm going to talk with you about the medieval memes generator created by KB National Library. So the question of today is how to bring medieval manuscripts from the cellars of the library to the bright daylight of online digital culture. First of all, what's a meme? It's a part of internet culture. Well-known near images combined with funny text which spread rapidly on the internet. The word meme was first used in 1976 by Richard Dawkins in his book The Selfish Gene as an attempt to explain how ideas replicate, mutate and evolve. It conveys the idea of a unit of cultural transmission or a unit of imitation. So, where are these memes? They're everywhere. Social media, in papers, presentations, stickers. Memes are mostly used by young people. But also other people, like this guy who said the following during his Clubhouse session. But how to make a meme? Well, you can use Photoshop or an app like Enlight, Capring or Mimetic. But most memes are made using a special website, a meme generator. This is a site on which you can choose an image and combine it with a text. There are many types of memes on the internet, and our favorites are of course the medieval memes. But we did not invent them, mediaevalists did. We have just realized that our heritage can be used as medieval meme. And we have a lot of heritage to be memified. So it began. This is our medieval meme site. We have done the first selection of images. You can make a meme and we explain what's happening on the image. We only help creating memes and present information about the historic background of the image. But why would you do this as a library? Medieval sources in the library are only consulted by experts or shown at exhibitions of museums. Young people do not encounter them in their daily life. It also does not play a role in their culture. So, the medieval meme generator is a way to let our heritage enter popular internet culture and regain an actual meaning for our times. It makes also people smarter and more creative. And also, it has a very nice bycatch. It has a positive influence on the image of our library. So, for instance, a politician wrote on Twitter that tax euros are well spent by our library. And a new colleague who said, well, I did not know that the library is so cool that we even have a meme generator. But how did we do it? It took us, rough librarians, 1.5 years in our free time to plan and construct this meme generator. But let's begin at the beginning. The first 4 months. Well, the idea started at a drinking party at the library where I met my colleague Robert Krom. I told him that I, as a creator of the digital collections, that it's very hard to mix the analog and the digital collections. He thought it over and came with the idea of building a meme generator using digitized heritage. But we tried to pitch our ideas for our colleagues, as most of them did not understand it. Libraries preserve, and most of them are not in touch with internet culture. So therefore, we visualized it. We try to show in an image what we try and what we want to do. We also created a team of rough librarians. Each of us had his own role. We kept contact through WhatsApp in the evening in a group called the Meme Lords. and all of us had our own role. Like, Ilse was our bad cop, I was the academic conscience, Robert was our creative genius, and finally, Rianne is our project manager. We had to explain the idea a lot of times, really, really, really a lot. And we also tried other formats for a different public. But still, finding funding for our plan was a big challenge. So we were really happy we found about the Creative Industries Fund NL, the Dutch Cultural Fund for Architecture, Design and Digital Culture, as well as every imaginable crossover. So they have a fund which aims at design companies which want to work with heritage, and that was exactly what we needed. The design company did a request for us. And one advice, if you're going to do the same kind of things, is to document as much as possible about your project, as you can reuse a lot later when asking for funding again. So we used OneNote. And of course also, it's a nice archive for future librarians and historians who want to write about popular culture on the internet. So we pitched our idea with a video, and this turned out to be a great idea, as the foundation could better imagine what we wanted to do exactly. We received a small amount of money to test our idea with our target group, young people between 15 and 35 years. So we organized a design thinking session in February 2020 to explore the humor of our heritage and invited a bunch of youth to help us. But yes, heritage and humor is not an easy combination, especially in a library. We asked stand-up comedian Marcel Hartenveld to create the right atmosphere and to make jokes instead of us. So the evening was a big success and the atmosphere was perfect.
Ik wist eerlijk gezegd echt niet dat er in de middeleeuwen dit soort vreemde tekeningen werden gemaakt. Dus dat vond ik wel grappig om te zien en ook wel raar, want ik heb nooit van dit soort tekeningen gezien.
Afgeleid door drie duiveltjes die speelt jazz. Ja, wat die wil weet ik niet precies, maar ja, dit is natuurlijk fantastisch dat die wordt ondergescheten.
Maar waarom?
Om hem af te leiden. Ja. Van, hij is eigenlijk bezig met studie, aan zijn boek aan het lezen, waarschijnlijk de Bijbel, iets over God.
Ah.
Dus hij moet zich echt...
So what happens here, first of all, the first youth in their first film said that he really did not know that medieval people were that funny, that there were so many funny images made in medieval periods. And then when the young people realized how funny and strange these images were, they started to ask questions. So what are we seeing here? What is the meaning of this image, and what is the historic context? So without we having to present the information, they came to us and asked about the images. So we were surprised that people were quite sure about which image they liked and could be mummified and which absolutely not. So we could immediately select the images we could use for the meme generator on the basis of these first results. After the session, we had to apply for the second part of the funding based on the first results of the design thinking session. We made a minimum viable product, a version of the meme generator with just enough features to be usable by early customers who can then provide feedback for future product development. And we had to tell the maker, the design agency, what we wanted and what we did not want. Our work can be summarized with the Drake meme. We wanted to make a simple meme generator to attract a young target group and bring them in contact with our medieval heritage. While there was a lot of construction going on the part of the design agency, we started to make the content from September last year, like the descriptions and the explanation videos. And of course, this all happened during the Corona period, so we did it from home, and we made it together in Zoom and in Teams. And it worked. And now over to our targets. So we promised the funder that within 2 years we will have 50,000 visitors of our website, 5,000 memes which were made, and 2.5 videos to be viewed. But after 6 months, we saw that almost 30,000 people visited our website, 16,000 memes were made. That's more than 3 times more than our 2-year target, and a whopping almost 60,000 videos were viewed. It turned out that these explanations videos were extremely popular, and they were used, for instance, in classrooms all over the world. And of course, we were really proud with all the feedback we got, first of all, from universities, from Princeton University, but also really nice reactions from all over the world, like from Siberia. And we also made animations with figures from the medieval manuscripts, just to experiment with new things. So perhaps after the meme generator, we can do more of this kind of projects for young people. So these were all kind of really nice things to experiment with our digital heritage. So we went viral on Reddit with our memes, and we got a lot of virtual awards for them. And also, it turned out that our digitized heritage is really nice to make Instagram reels and TikTok videos. So we can tell short stories about our collections within 13 seconds. We also had some merchandise, like laptop stickers, stamps, and postcards. So, and now, what started as a medieval meme generator turned out to be much more. Now we are going to think about what we are going to do next in future. Thank you very much for your attention.